go right here and then go to this young lady. We'll wrap up. Yes, sir.
All right, Mike. I'll be honest with you. You're very eloquent. You're a great speaker. I aspire to be as good as you are. But my biggest concern is, I mean, you've been in Congress a long time. And we've had a lot of problems in your district as far as our manufacturing base, our private sector productivity. And I mean, I hear talk about it, but I don't hear see any action. I think it's a contributing factor in a lot of our shortfalls with health care, our debt ceiling, you know, underfunded schools. I think that it attributes to all of it because that's how we generate our prosperity through our private sector.
Right.
And it's been eroded. We're bulldozing our factories. We've got two factories in my, we've got one commercial building and another factory in my, right in my neighborhood that's going to get bulldozed in the next 6 months. I mean, this is a contributing factor in our decline. And, you know, China, I mean, why don't, I mean, they're growing. Their growth rate is exponential in comparison to ours. And I'm tired of hearing the talk. I want to see the action. You know, talk is cheap. We need fair trade in this country. I mean, there is easy answers to solve the problem. And I mean, I know you're going to be in there for the next 2 years. I hope you do a great job. And I have faith in you, but I want to hear you when you go on national television, when you're speaking to your fellow colleagues. I want to hear some repeal of the trade laws, some mention of it that your party wrote, which was the GATT agreement and the Democrats signed. And I think both parties are complicit and culpable. And we need some help in this area because, again, the erosion of our industrial base is affecting us on a lot of different areas, and we need help, so help us.
Right. Thanks. I appreciate your passion and your respectful tone in the midst of that. Just know that I'm just as frustrated with the shuttered factories as you are.
Bulldozed
factories, breaks my heart. We have got to take decisive action to get in the competitive global marketplace in ways that where American workers can win again. Frankly, it's what I welcomed about the president's speech. Is in his speech Tuesday night, he talked about how we make the United States more competitive. You and I probably will have a reasonable difference of opinion on some trade agreements. I don't say every trade agreement that's been done has been perfect, but I hold to the principle that expanding where we can sell what we make and what we grow is good for our economy. I think trade as a general rule, I believe trade means jobs.
Exactly.
But let me also say, I think we have got to begin to think outside the box. And I'd love to send you a copy of the speech that I gave in Detroit about how we create a tax code, a regulatory environment. I mean, here's the point. People love to throw the blame at labor in this country for why we're losing jobs. I will promise you, when I talk to international business leaders, when I talk to international experts, when you're talking about complex manufacturing, which maybe you've been involved in your life, I haven't. When you're talking about complex manufacturing, the labor cost differential here and there is not really that great. I mean, you have to hire skilled labor. Those are people that have to be educated, have to be talented. I mean, so the real difference, I believe, is the tax code, the regulatory environment, and those are the things we've got to be very aggressive about, very visionary about if we're going to compete to succeed in the world. Follow up.
Well, those jobs were supposed to stay here. That was the whole pretense for the trade law. When they went through and they said we're going to export the most cumbersome, most labor-intensive jobs, but we don't have any of the high tech here. I mean, it's been exported too. All your cell phones, all your complex engineered industrial products, all of your television sets, everything that was complex is being done in China too. They have the technology, and we have nothing. We're basically collapsing from within, and it's in your district. It's happening. It's right in front of your face. So I just want your help. I want you to focus on that, and it's fair trade. It's not free trade. Fair trade, I mean, we've got to trade. I'm not talking about isolationism. I'm not talking the opposite end of the spectrum. What I'm talking about is common sense. Yeah. And common sense is that we have to be productive, and we can't let the government keep us from being able to compete. And we don't have even the match to strike the flame. I mean, we have basically been gutted, and we need help.
Yeah. Well, agreed. Thank you.
Okay.